Good morning. So I was able to test that focuser, the shoestring astronomy focuser. It worked very well. If you watch my first video, I configured it up to the sequence generator probe and connecting the autofocuser there. And once I am done, I did not take that into the night. So I was able to take it into the night. I was able to focus it properly. All you have to do is press that focus button and it focuses it. It's pretty neat. It's not difficult at all to process. I'll show you my workflow. I'm also trying to take a picture of SH2-129. It is one of the nebula in Cepheus constellation. I'll show you the workflow. It's very faint. I tried to take a picture of it. It's not easy at all. I pushed up to 3 minutes. I don't get much, so I'll show you the workflow. Thanks. Hey folks, I was able to test that focuser. If you had seen my last video, I completed up to configuring this focuser in Sequence Generator Pro. In this video, part 2, I'm just continuing showing that once if you use the Sequence Generator Pro, if you go to the either manually like focus control and press the start button, and then it brings up this autofocus running. What it does is it looks at the HFR, the half flux radius, and it goes like one way and other way, and then it finds the lowest point, and then it points it back to that point, right? So it goes up and it goes down. So there are a couple of things that I learned doing this one. So one of them is it actually moves pretty slow. So if you change the filter or something, and if you wanted to use this to autofocus, it might take a little bit more time than usual because it needs to find the exact focus. So what I ended up doing is I end up actually focusing it again in sharp cap or somewhere outside, like manually. I mean, of course, when I say manual, using the motor itself, but I was actually moving it by pressing the buttons. And once that is kind of nearby, then I come back here and I let the Sequence Generator Pro do a running automatically. So anyway, once this is done, so here is one of the picture. I just downloaded it. The stars looks pretty much in focus. Once this is done, if you can zoom in a little bit, you know, you can see they look pretty good. Manually, I had doubts whether I'm focusing properly or not, but at least to some extent, these are like nice, not too bad. I was going into the edges and seeing if there is anything wrong. They look okay. So here is how it works. Like right now, it's downloading it and then it automatically starts. So I set up the focus to run automatically like every 30 minutes. So while the sequence is running, if it passes 30 minutes or if there is a 15 degree change, I don't know if the 15 degree change worked. It said like you don't have a way to calculate the weather or the temperature. So I think it turned it off. But I think since I don't have a way to calculate, you know, the up and down in terms of the weather, it didn't allow me to change that 15 degree, but it allowed me to do it every 30 minutes. I think 30 minutes is a little less, but I think it's okay from what I can see, because I'm taking like really short exposures. And if these things are out of focus, I have to lose quite a bit. So it takes not too long though. It takes like probably a couple of minutes. And then it does pretty much the same routine. Sometimes I felt the routine is actually a lot shorter than the other ones. Sometimes it actually is a lot longer. I don't know. Like the half-lex radius calculation that it is doing, it is basically looking for a lowest value, looking for the trend, and then basically, you know, doing some kind of a measurement of which one is the lowest or the average of the lowest or whatever, and then going back, trying to go back to that one. And pretty much it sets it there, and it takes like 1% to 100%, and once it is done, it moves on and goes to the next activity. So here is the SH-129 nebula. I took HA almost close to 120 seconds, that's like 2 minutes, and I pushed oxygen up to like 3 minutes. So here is how it looks like. I think I need to spend maybe like close to 6 to 7 hours. Once I'm done, I will share my workflow and all with you. Thank you for watching Clear Skies. I hope this video helps someone who is looking for similar focuser.